is with Dr. Alim Siddiqui, professor in the University of California, San Diego. Hi, Alim.
Nice to meet you.
I would like to know when you started your interest in science.
Oh, I grew up in India, and in my undergraduate, I took biology and chemistry, and then in my master's program, I took genetics, and it's only after taking classes in genetics, my interest in research became very strong. And at the time when I was in India, one of the Indian scientists in America got a Nobel Prize, and his name was Dr. Hargobind Khurana, who had synthesized the gene. So when I saw the news, I was very excited because I was already studying genetics, and I decided this is what I want to do.
Okay. I know, actually, do you work with mitochondria? And I would like to know about your work in hepatitis C and B and mitochondria.
Yeah. So my research is on hepatitis B virus and hepatitis C virus infection of human liver. And both of these viruses cause chronic disease, and their infection can progress to liver cancer. So my interest has been understanding the molecular basis of liver disease pathogenesis, how the liver becomes sick. So when looking at the level of the cell, so we looked at this infected cells and we found that one of the organelles within the cell called mitochondria was damaged. So we studied the damage of mitochondria, tried to understand what the damage translates into in terms of the disease. Now we know that the mitochondrial damage actually is the reason how people infected with hepatitis B and hepatitis C virus become chronically infected, develop chronic infection. So the cellular factors that are recruited to mitochondria facilitate the establishment of chronic and persistent infection in cells. So that is the molecular basis of disease. And we further found that the ability of these viruses to avoid the innate immunity. Innate immunity is the first line of defense against disease, and that innate immunity is suppressed by viruses, and the mitochondria plays a major role in facilitating the suppression of innate immunity.
Our collaboration project is interesting for you in dengue virosis, mitochondria during dengue virus infection.
Yes. So dengue virus belongs to the same virus that hepatitis C does. They belong to the family of viruses called flaviviruses and flavivirid. So dengue virus is like hepatitis C virus, also a single stranded RNA genome. And innate immunity by dengue virus is also follows the same pathway as the hepatitis C does. And so the fact that dengue virus causes infection suppresses innate immunity must be following the same mechanism. And that's why you're interested in mitochondrial dynamics by dengue virus is similar to what hepatitis C virus does.
Okay. Finally, I would like to know about your experiences in this Congress of the Virology Network in Mexico.
I was very impressed by attending the conference and the talks and the talking to the students. And my first reaction was that all the students can deliver the talk in English. They all have the potential to talk in English. They may be shy not speaking English, but when they get on the stage, they were able to give very good talks. And their interest is is stimulated by all the culinary talks people have given here. And the high quality of the science by the major speakers here can stimulate the students to do the best work possible. And all the talks have been centered around viral infection, innate immunity, the RNA replication, and what happens to the RNA, because most of the viral infections we have been dealing here are RNA viruses. So I think meetings like this can benefit young students. There should be even more meetings in more specialized areas of virology. And that will help the students develop, because America is sitting right next door, and they are the best, they have the best science going, and if you, by inviting people, you can provide the stimulus in among young students to do the best science. And also sending the students on scholarships for a year or two to work in labs and bring the technology and the technical know-how and also the knowledge. So Mexico can very well benefit, can be heavily benefited by this kind of collaborations and by this kind of scholarship awards to students to visit American labs. And I can tell you, the Americans love Mexico, and I don't know anybody who not want to come to Mexico. Everybody wants to come to Mexico. And they like to come with their families even. So it's a stimulus for Americans to come. It's very easy to fly here. And for Mexican students, it's very easy to go across the border and work in labs.
Okay. Thank you, Ali. I appreciate your participation in this Congress.
Thank you very much. Thank you.